Our next presentation has a little bit of backstory, and it comes together as a result of the diplomatic work of our lead curator, Dr. Ramiro Matos, that he was able to gather several teams of researchers who hadn't previously worked together to really conduct the most comprehensive approximation of the Cusco of the Inca moment. So I'd like to introduce three colleagues who worked on this project, will be presenting today: José Alejandro Beltrán-Caballero and Ricardo Mar of the Universitat Rovira y Virgili in Spain, and Crayla Alfaro, architect, main architect in Cusco, Peru, and they have worked on a groundbreaking project that offers a new vision of the ancient city of Cusco that we're privileged to learn about today. And I want to thank very specially Alcalde Mayor Luis Flores, who made that work possible, opened up the municipality of Cusco in a way that was extremely generous and cooperative. Thank you, Luis. And Ricardo.
Thank you. Well, it's an honor for us to present here the result of 5 years of archaeological work done on Cusco urbanism. We would like to thank Dr. Ramiro Matos and José Barreiro and the museum for this opportunity. Several archaeologists and architects from Cusco, USA, and Spain have participated in this research. This is the scientific base that had allowed us to propose a virtual reconstruction of Cusco. You will see in the exhibition the amazing work done by Dan Davis as media manager and IDEUM to integrate the archaeological research, this archaeological research, in a multimedia presentation. Now, architect Crayla Alfaro and Dr. José Alejandro Beltrán Caballero will talk about the process of this project.
As Dr. Mar said, I would like to thank all those that made possible for us to be here, especially Dr. Matos, who is a pride for Peruvians, as well as to Mr. Luis Flores, former mayor of Cusco, who trusted and supported this project. The reconstruction of urban layout of Cusco as capital and center of the Tawantinsuyu is in many ways an incomplete task. Despite the important archaeological studies conducted so far, there is no consensus on how was the urban shape of the ancient city. Consequently, images of Inca space include in popular edition, book, and public tourist guides are incomplete and sometimes distort the perception of the general public about ancient Cusco, Cusqueños themselves, or tourists who visit the city, is a set of fragments of walls, something incorporated into the facade of colonial and republican building or on terraces that hold a big part of the historic city. This Cusco, Washington, Tarragona, Spain, international cooperation project seek to contribute to solving this problem through the urban study of the historical center of Cusco. Rehabilitation of historic center and their architectural heritage is one of the cornerstones of urban development in Latin America. This is an issue that particularly affects the city with a prestigious heritage included by UNESCO in the World Heritage List. To operate in a historic city is necessary to know its history from urban solid basis. This has been our objective in the case of Cusco. A cooperation between architects and archaeologists to improved the knowledge of the archaeological heritage. Tourism is an ability and economic engineering. Unfortunately, of them prestigious history center and their monuments as cathedrals, monasteries, palaces, and monumental square have become open-air museums where the original population has been cornered by hotels and tourist establishments. So this project is not only addressed to the tourist visitors or the academic community. We are trying to arrive to every Cusco inhabitant. Management of the historic city in the 21st century presents many challenges. One is to develop economical, sustainable tourism that respect the natural environment. However, it must also provide to citizens the living conditions required by progress the contemporary city. Enable living in historic city require the execution of public work, providing service and benefits to citizens. It also requires awareness of our past. This is target our project has raised relative to Cusco to better understand the root of the past of our city.
Hello, everyone. I was telling to my colleagues that we are so lucky to be the last in this session today, because all the works we have seen today are going to put in context our work about Cusco. Cusco is one of the most remarkable examples of a pre-Columbian city in the Americas. Its archaeological remains have been fossilized underneath the colonial city, making possible the reconstruction of the urban shape of the whole ancient capital. This is the final aim of our project, Cusco, a new vision of the ancient city, tackling the last years by the Municipalidad del Cusco, the Smithsonian Institution, National Museum of the American Indian, and our university, Universitat Rovira y Virgili from Tarragona. Here you can see our proposal of the virtual reconstruction of Cusco, built from the integration of several strategies of research of ancient archaeological remains. The compilation of archaeological information about Inca Cusco started in the 19th century with works of travelers and explorers who visited the region looking for ancient remains. On the left, we can see the plan published by Ephraim George Esquire in 1877 as a result of his expeditions in Peru. On the right, you have the detailed plan of the city drawn some years later by German archaeologist Max Uhle. We have to remark that in 1900, the compilation of Inca walls was made by Uhle and include the first classification of constructive techniques. Through the 20th century, the most important Peruvian archaeologists continued with the study of Inca remains in Cusco and the research of ancient documents and descriptions from the 16th century stored in the archives. Some of them are José Uriel García, Luis Eduardo Barcárcel, Manuel Chávez Bayón, or Luis Barreda Murillo. In the 1970s, the publication of Arquitectura Inca by Graziano Gasparini and Luis Margolies opened a new phase. Works done by John H. Rowe, Tom Swidima, Janet Cherbondi, Susan Niles, Jean-Francois Bouchard, Jean-Pierre Protzen, Leonardo Mino, or John Hislop, among others, are part of this new impulse in the study of the Andean world. Scholars have continued studying Cusco urbanism. Here you can see on the left the plan of Cusco, published by Brian S. Bauer in 2008, and on the right, the plan published by Ian Farrington in 2014. However, we think that the best topographical information of the Inca remains of Cusco, published until now, were produced in 1972 by Santiago Agurto as part of the task to include Cusco in the World Heritage List. This work was published 8 years later in 1980, and these are some of the detailed plans produced by Agurto. This is the layout of the terraces in and outside the ceremonial center proposed by Agurto itself. Our research has been based on the elaboration of a unique document in which we have incorporated the data gathered by Agurto and the archaeological excavations completed in the last 3 years. This is the archaeological map of the city and the valley produced for our team from 2009 to 2012. Over the satellite photograph, you can see the modern topography of Cusco, and in red, the Inca remains. The archaeological map is a GIS that has been complemented by using the aerial photographs from 1956. Modern constructions have extended through the valley, to the entire valley, frequently covering the Inca remains. These photographs have allowed us to complete the layout of the Inca terraces and channels that have entirely transformed the natural environment of the valley with the foundation of the big capital by Pachacuti. The methodology used has included the registry of colonial buildings. Topography of the first colonial constructions has preserved the system of terraces that served to give urban form to the ceremonial center, to the Inca city. San Blas colonial district is an excellent example. Located next to the urban limit of the ceremonial center, it was built as an expansion of the first colonial Spanish city. Colonial constructions in this district occupied an extensive series of Inca terraces intended to agrarian production. On the right, we have an image of the colonial buildings, and on the left, the reconstruction of the Inca terrace system. In San Blas, terraces are the retaining walls of old roads included in the colonial layout of the city. In other cases, terraces have been preserved under modern buildings. Archaeological information of these elements has allowed us to draw the plan of this urban system and recover a current image of its configuration. Roads, huacas, terraces form a continuous system that gives shapes to the Inca landscape and the valley. Here you have the Huaca Mesa Redonda, also known as Pachatosa. The integration of all the information, roads, channels, terraces, in one document has allowed us to understand the Inca strategy to organize the natural environment. Here we can see the quality of the information of the aerial photographs from 1956. In this photograph, we can see a series of rectangular platforms as those in Yucay. in some places, aerial photographs show a sequence with up to 20 curved steep terraces, as those in Pisac. Here you have the 1956 aerial photograph from San Blas to Pachatosa. Archaeological photo interpretation show how Inca builders transformed the entire hill with a continuous series of those curved step terraces adapted to the contours of the topography. From Pachatosa to Cachimayo River, over here, it extends an area that can be subdivided into zones. This is the current state. These are the photographs from 1956. And this is our interpretation. You have the first zone, the upper part of a stepped slope that was transformed by Inca builders with a continuous series of terraces. The lower part of the slope is much more regular and gentler. So it was organized by a large rectangular platforms supported by retaining walls whose heights adapted to different terrain slopes. Huayracpunco Huaca system remains as part of the religious life in Cusco, offerings of coca leaves and other products are visible inside the carved rock, which shows the continuity of the Andean spirituality. In the Cachimayo River, we can find a place called Inquiltambo, which is a testimony of the Inca skill to transform until the last corner of the valley. This extensive agricultural terraces system extends along almost half kilometer of the course of this river, the river Cachimayo. Inca walls and ceilings disappeared, leave traces on a carved rock, and niches were excavated as part of internal rooms. The ceremonial complex was organized on several levels around the rock. This image shows the present state. Terraces on the rock are the clues that have allow us proposing a virtual reconstruction of the compound. Changing the scenery, the low part of the valley was a terrain of gentle slopes that extended between the current Avenida de la Cultura and the current airport located here. Although today the area is completely covered by modern constructions, the 1956 aerial photographs clearly document the retaining walls built to hold agricultural terraces and the channels traced to drain the wetlands and to evacuate rainwater. The photo interpretation shows the Inca retaining walls and the network of channels partially preserved until 1956. In order to understand the enormous dimension of this transformation, it is necessary to explain the process of the geological origin of the valley. At the end of the Pleistocene, after the last glaciation, the thawing of the glaciers left behind a big lake that occupied the complete extension of the valley. This lake was named Morkil. The lake dried up due to the rupture of a dam in the Angostura area. As a consequence, a series of wetlands remained as the last trace of a big lake. When the Inca began their expansion out of Cusco region, the base of the way of the Watanay Valley was occupied by that big wetland lagoon that was fed by torrents of water that descend off the slopes of the valley. The refoundation of Cusco involved the complete reorganization of the hydraulic system of the valley. Rivers from the top were channeled following a geometrical trace. The ceremonial center of the ancient capital extended between channels Sapi and Tuyumayo. Architectural documentation of the colonial buildings has been fundamental to understand the ancient Inca topography hidden under the colonial buildings. For instance, colonial facades in Plaza de Armas give the ancient profile of Aucaipata Square. In this regard, the study of the so-called Palacio del Inca Roca shows that the existing walls constitute the perimeter of a large platform. Its architectural shape and its Quechua name, Hatun Rumiyok, or Big Rock, exclude its interpretation as a palace. It should be a big ushnu, surrounded by one of the most extraordinary Inca walls in Cusco, which had an important religious role in the urban layout of the Inca ceremonial center. Below, we have some images of the remains of an Inca building associated with the Huaca. These Inca walls have been preserved in the garden of the colonial palace. The relationship between the great Hatun Rumiyok Huaca and Cusco topography has allowed us to propose a hypothesis of the reconstruction of this Huaca. If we establish a relationship between Hatun Rumiyok and the Inca walls located behind the buildings of Suecia Street, it is possible to reconstruct a system. It's possible to reconstruct a system of a retaining walls that serve to give shape to the natural slope. This is an example of the walls of Suecia Street, which include a monumental door similar to that of Saisawaman. This one. Terraces preserved behind the cathedral extend below the Cuesta del Almirante and link to the walls that hold the Plaza del Tricentenario and the Balcón Cusqueño, and then continue to Texecocha over here. If we observe the zigzag path and the site topography, we think it is possible to imagine that these two projections of terraces could correspond to a large rocks as Hatun Rumiyok. Numerous excavations accomplished during the constant transformations of the city have given us fundamental information to reconstruct an image of the Inca city that lies beneath. The excavations at Nazarenas Monastery had allowed it identifying walls of canchas, hallways, and double jam doors. Inca canchas found in Nazarenas Monastery have been included in the reconstruction of Inca Cusco urban layout. Other archaeological excavations, as this one in Casa Concha, have provided more information to continue proposing a probable reconstruction of Inca urban space shape. Sometimes that is just foundations such as these found in the second courtyard of this house. Colonial house was built using a very likely Inca wall preserved in its height. In all its height, sorry. It should be part of a callanca. It has several trapezoidal doors and niches, and interior niches. To understand the architectural remains of Casa Concha, it is necessary to integrate them in the Inca Cusco plan. They were part of a great Hatun Cancha compound. Hatun Cancha walls run along Loreto Street, Maruri, San Agustin, Herrajes, and Triunfo. Although today this huge compound is divided by colonial streets, these four corners show its original unity. The interior of Hatun Cancha was decorated with a continuous series of niches, as this seen in Catalina Monastery Garden. Casa Concha excavations get urban significance then in Inca Cusco layout. This is the detailed plan of the archaeological data in the sector of Coricancha, and some images of the Inca remains that can be seen in the streets. This is the result of the whole urban interpretation of this zone. Now here, it is the Cusicancha sector and some images of urban archaeological park. And this is the synthesis of the urban interpretation of the area. Finally, this is the sector of Plaza de Armas. Here we have the walls that were part of the Hatun Cancha and the Casana compounds. This is the synthesis of our interpretation in this area. In order to complete the topographical shape of the ceremonial center, it is necessary to go to Sacsayhuamán to get an image to its architecture from the archaeological remains. It is very surprising the role of the five outcrops that conditioned the disposition of the six walls and the buildings. A very good example is this big rock associated with a foundation and a group of walls located at the east corner of the area. Here we are talking about a waka with architectural remains associated to an outcrop rock, as we have seen in Inquiltambo. On the left, you have the archaeological remains, and on the right, the reconstructive plan of the religious compound around the rock. Here, we have proposed a 3D reconstruction of the compound. This is just an approximation of the form of the building that help us to understand the architectural dimension of this waka. The disposition of rocks R1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 show their importance in architectural planning of the Torreones compound and the layout of the huge zigzag walls. This building, known as the Muyuk Marca, is one of the most interesting structures in Sacsayhuamán. The extraordinary Inca models, which are part of the collections of Museo Inca, are a great tool to propose a restitution of the buildings. These two in particular show three terraces, over which rise three towers, two floor high, probably a symbolic or votive representation of Sacsayhuaman. Inca models are a great tool to propose a restitution of the buildings. If we consider the distribution of the preserved foundations, the position of open spaces, and the water system, it is possible to continue with the architectural interpretation and consider a 3D image of the Torreone sector. This is an image of the circular building foundations that is all we have on the site. For a virtual reconstruction of this building, we have an important painting from the Escuela Cusqueña called El Milagro del Sunturwasi, which gives us a valuable information about the architectural form of the circular torreón of Muyumarca. The painting shows the moment when the Virgin Mary went down and saved the Spaniards from Inca troops. On the left, we can see a stepped building that may refer to Muyumarca. This is an image of our proposal of restitution of Torreone sector integrated to the zigzag walls. And here, a perspective view of the so-called La Fortaleza sector. To conclude, Cusco today keeps the keys of its planning in Inca time. Inca channels continue as part of Cusco Historic Center, and the archaeological information had allowed to reconstruct a system of narrow, elongated terraces parallel to the channels of both rivers, designed to stabilize the slope of both canyons. These terraces were preserved under the colonial buildings, are preserved under the colonial buildings. The steepest part down from Sacsayhuaman was reshaped, building a retaining wall system that ran obliquely the future urban space. Here we observe the zigzag system we talked before. Archaeology shows that the Capañán four branches Archaeology shows that the Capañán four branches already existed before the refounding of Cusco. These four branches were integrated into the design process of urban space. This is an image of Triunfo Street excavations with a Quilque wall which runs in the same direction that the Tawantinsuyu Road. The shape of Aucaipara Plaza here is due to its position between the retaining walls behind the cathedral and the River Sapi. And River Sapi here. Intipampa Plaza here was linked to the activities of Coricancha, and Limacpampa Plaza gave access to the city from the Collasuyo. Two ceremonial roads linked Sacsayhuaman with the Coricancha and the Coricancha with the Aucaipata Square. These two streets served to fix the limits of the largest and most important administrative compound in the Inca city, the Hatun Cancha, which housed the Agliahuasi, or the House of the Virgins, the Pucamarca, and other estate compounds. the excellent condition of its perimeter walls allow us to reconstruct it as described by the sources as a microcosm closed by a wall of its own and its own an autonomous urban organization. The nature of archaeological data suggests a process of progressive urban design. Many of these features were defined on the ground as they were being constructed. Cusco was the result of a state operation ordered by Pachacuti. Archaeological data suggests a process of progressive urban design. And we know that Pachacuti ordered making clay models. They were used for several project organizations. However, the delineation of the boundaries of plazas, streets, compounds, and buildings was the result of a gradual design system of the urban space. And in order to finish the presentation, I would like to show you a quick image of the video of this 3D. Here we are. No, you're not here. We had a video. This one, yeah. Here. Okay. This is an approximation of the model you are going to see today on the exhibition that has been enriched by the media group here at the Smithsonian. An amazing job they have produced in order to all the visitors of this exhibition have the chance to understand better how Cusco was built and how Cusco remains are still part of the contemporary city. The work we have done here is to put the different materials in this model so we can have a point of discussion about Inca Cusco at its time. Thank you so much.
Excellent. Well, a lot of work went into that, as you can tell.